distance of my head said, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but hey, you gotta be.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying, gotta keep my there's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. The struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most, yeah. Just gotta keep going.
Maybe he'll come back.
The show's over.
Maybe they'll be in later.
Hunger Games, I would probably win because I feel like I'm more of a go-getter. I'm more of an attacker, and I'm more of a problem solver. So I would win.
Honestly, I think it would be pretty close, but it would probably be me because my legs are a bit longer, so I could run a little faster than you, and I would just outlast you because of my survival skills.
Who do I think would die in the Hunger Games near you? So this is the thing. I think it's going to be a tie. I think we're both going to give up at the beginning. We know we can't play this game. We know it. So just, we're going to let them eat us, whatever they do. I don't know, kill us in the beginning.
So who would last longer in the Hunger Games? This one's going to surprise you, but I'm going to go with Rahel. Bet you were all thinking I was going to say me. The deal is with Rahel is I think that her strategy would be so unorthodox that every other opponent would be just, everyone at every other district would be so utterly confused when at the beginning everybody's rushing for the weapons and Rahel takes her time and then grabs like a bottle of Febreze and a stapler. And people are going, what's she going to do with that? You know, I've got a knife, I've got a gun, everyone's got like water to survive. And somehow it all, through weird luck, saves her entire life. Like she squirts Febreze on something and the smell goes away so she can't be detected by her number one opponent. And it just all falls into place, and I think no one's going to know what her moves are because they're going to be trying to think ahead of her, but even she hasn't a thought ahead of her, so she ends up just completely wiping everybody else out who overthought the whole game. So Rahel ends up winning the Hunger Games.
Honestly, I have faith in myself, and I would like to say me, but I just feel like once you've defeated malaria, there's really nothing you can't do. Like, you're basically undefeated. So, for that reason, I would probably have to say you.
If Rahel and I were in the Hunger Games, she would definitely win because she's actually seen them.
Rue, I've never watched the Hunger Games, but I know I can beat you because we would all be hungry, and the only thing left would be Kudfo and Injera. And guess what? You don't eat that stuff. I win.
I think that if we were in the Hunger Games, Rahel would absolutely last longer than I. She knows that. I know that. I think everybody knows that. I have no stamina, and Rahel's got endurance. She's got that strength and endurance, so I definitely think she would beat me on that one.
If it were to come to it, between the two of us, I think I would last longer, you know, in the Hunger Games, simply because I'm very talkative and social, so I think I could establish bonds with other districts early on, you know, get myself to the last round.
Alright, so if Rahel won the lottery, I think the first thing she would do is hire a chef who will make her whatever food she wants at whatever time of the day. Then she would hire a voice coach and set up a YouTube account and set off to become a famous singer. I think that's what she would do with her money.
What's the first thing Rue would buy if she won the lottery? Well, I say nothing. Because Rue, I don't think you like spending your own money. You probably wouldn't mind spending other people's money, but you're kind of stingy with your own money. So I think the question should be, what would Rue buy if other people won the lottery? In that case, I don't know what people will buy you, but I'll build you your own karaoke room because I know you love to sing and you sound good too.
Hey Rahel, I think the first thing you'd buy if you won the lottery would be gifts for other people because you're very generous.
If you won the lottery, what is the first thing you would buy? I think you would buy the Avengers. I think you would buy the whole cast and crew. I think you would buy the whole lot if you could. So I don't blame you for that. I think it's a good investment. But yeah, I just think if you were going to be true to yourself, that is the only thing that would make sense for you to buy.
Hi, Rahel. I think your spirit animal is a canary bird because you both like to sing a lot.
If Rahel were a sheep.
What's Rahel's spirit animal and why? Well, I think that could be a dog. I think that because Rahuye is very sweet, cuddly, very soft, very loving, very loyal. Yep, that's my final answer.
I want to say, I believe your spirit animal, if I were to choose one spirit animal to represent you, would probably be Bernard the Bear. Simply because, well, you know why.
So, what's Rahel's spirit animal? That's an easy one for me. Nothing screams Rahel more than Tasmanian Devil. Tasmanian Devil, nocturnal, carnivorous marsupial. Characterized by a stocky and muscular build, black fur, pungent odor, extremely loud and disturbing screech, keen sense of smell, and ferocious while feeding. This one from Wikipedia. Despite its appearance, the devil is capable of surprising speed and endurance and can climb trees and swim across rivers. Tasmanian devils are adorable, ferocious, and incredible stamina, and don't mess with them while they're eating.
Hey, Rahel. Your spirit animal is definitely Bernard the Bear because you're both so silly and so cute.
What is your spirit animal? Well, I think if we just pull up points A, B, and C, X, Y, and Z, I would just have to say Bernard the Bear. I just think that's the only appropriate answer. Other than a Cheshire Cat. I think you could be a Cheshire Cat because you're always grinning. Always up to no good.
What is your spirit animal? It's Bernard. It's Bernard the Bear. That's your spirit animal. Oh, yes.
Hey, Rahel. I think the easiest thing for college would be, for you, making friends and being social.
The easiest thing for Rahel in college, I think, is gonna be social life, making new friends and having a fun social life.
The easiest thing for you in college is gonna be getting used to the beautiful Bay Area.
I would say making friends. Kind of the social life aspect of college, I think she's gonna have an easy time. Rahuye is very easy to get along with and is fun and fun loving. And I think college environment is totally made for her. I think she's gonna thrive in those areas for sure. So that's my answer there.
The easiest thing for Rahel when she goes to college will probably be adjusting and making new friends, but also like adjusting to the more laid back Bay Area lifestyle. That's very much like in Rahel's realm. I'm really excited to see her go up there and make all these new friends and meet all these new people.
What's gonna be easiest for you in college is probably sleeping. I know you love to do it. I love to do it. And I think it may be even so easy for you, you might miss some classes. But yeah, I think that's going to be easiest for you.
I think for sure the easiest thing for you in college is going to be making friends. You're a very social person, and I admire that about you.
College will be a breeze for you, simply because I think you'll be comfortable a little sooner than most freshmen, because you got two older cousins and a really good friend that all care about you and all here for you, so that your experience goes smoothly.
The warmest memory I have with Rahel is all the family trips we've been to, and when we go to Ethiopia, especially with all the cousins.
Some of our favorite memories.
are of Rahel and the family coming over to the house and going swimming with us and just watching Rue and Sophie engage with the dogs. Because at first they were really scared of them, and then as time went on, they just loved them to death. So I have so many pictures of Rahel sitting there just hugging and loving on all the dogs, but especially the little Shih Tzus.
One thing that I know will always get a good laugh out of her, which is to talk about her little ginger thumb. So we always have a good fun about that, and I think we always will.
Funniest thing that Rahel and I have ever done, there's just so many funny things we've done, but probably anything involving like messing with our parents or messing with our mom or messing with Hef, our bunny.
My warmest Rahel memory, this was a few years ago. Rahel had come up to spend some time here with us alone, and I was sitting on this couch right here, and Rahel Ye came up and cuddled up, like on my thigh. She was in a fetal position and just enjoying really just a beautiful moment with me. And I was just caressing her a little bit. And she said, Auntie Weenie, you know, I love you so much. And you're like a second mommy to me. And I love your house so much. And I love your kids so much. And I wished I could, this could be my house. And that was just so incredibly sweet. And I remembered that every time I would talk to her, every time I would see her again. And that's Rahel Ye, sweet, incredibly sweet and loving, and just really family loving and family centered, and just makes you feel good kind of girl. So Rahel Ye, I love you so much, beautiful girl. Love you back 1,000 times.
The warmest memory I have of Rahel is when she was in elementary school. I went one day to visit her. I think she had forgotten her lunch, so I took her lunch, and it was lunchtime. She took me, held my hands, and walked me around the grounds of the school, introducing me to anybody who would listen, saying, "Hi, this is my mom. She's so nice, isn't she?" So, Rue, you gave me that gift years ago, and to this day, it's the warmest thing that I think of when I think of you.
Hardest thing for Rue in college. Well, I won't be missing Injera. And but I think missing a family is gonna be the hardest.
That's
I
funny.
Know your mommy's girl. And I remember Soph, Dad used to tuck her in. I think she's Daddy's girl, but your mom used to fall asleep in your room when she was reading you bedtime stories and tucking you in. So you gotta miss your mom and your dad, of course. And getting used to that homesickness is probably the hardest thing for you.
The hardest thing in college for Rue is gonna be missing her family.
I think the hardest thing in college will be waking up on time for her classes and being organized and remembering all the stuff she has to do for her classes on time.
The hardest thing for sure is gonna be not procrastinating anymore. But I know you can do it because obviously I did it or I'm working on it.
I think that the hardest thing in Rahel's first year of college will probably be the class she is least interested in, whatever it is.
Wake up on time. It's hard, I know. Don't do early classes if you can. It's gonna be tough for you. I literally can see it. I can imagine you not wanting to get out of bed, but you're gonna do it. I have faith in you.
But the hardest thing for Rahel in college is going to be waking up on time for class every day. She's gonna need 3 alarms every single morning. Hopefully she has no morning classes, but waking up in the morning, getting to class on time, really anything involving that.
So what's going to be hardest for you in college? Going to be honest, probably studying, putting in the work, I find it hard, you find it hard. I know this because we've both found ourselves in those 2 a.m. FaceTimes where we're talking about all the work we haven't done and still need to do. Let's hope that doesn't happen. It's gonna happen. But anyway, okay, that's it.
Hi, Rahel, my love. Congratulations. I'm so happy I have come so far in such a condition. You have been such a lovely, beautiful, wise, and kind granddaughter. I can't wish for a better granddaughter. You are such a wonderful daughter, granddaughter, a good student, a good friend. In every aspect, you have made me happy. If I could say I'm proud, I am very proud to be your grandmother. And best wishes for the rest of your life. Enjoy your schoolwork, work hard, and God willing, I may be present at your graduation from the university. I wish you all the best for success and bright future. Be as good as you have been. Continue in such a wonderful, straight road. And don't forget to remember your parents, grandparents, and your creator above all. Good luck. Good luck in every aspect. Your grandma, your loving grandma. Mwah.
Dear Rahel, I'm so glad that I am still alive. I was present when you were born, and I was there to dedicate you to God in the church few months after your birth. And I was there also when you finished grade 12. And I'm very happy and I'm very glad that I baptize you in the name of Jesus in the Addis Ababa Church. And now I'm privileged enough to be still alive at your graduation at the end of grade 12. This is a wonderful time. God has been good to you. God has been good to your parents. And God has been good to your grandparents as well. So today, we are privileged to be present and to be alive at your graduation day and to praise God for the many years we have enjoyed together. And we praise God for your success. I wish you more and more success in the future. I may or may not be present for your graduation at the end of college, but I wish you much of God's blessing, wisdom, understanding for your studies, for your Christian growth, and for your personal development. So on this day of your graduation, at the end of grade 12, I am glad to send you this message from the bottom of my heart that God bless you. The God who has blessed you in the past may continue to bless you in the future. Many, many happy years will be lying ahead of you. May God help you to realize those many years to perform wonderful acts of education and Christian experience. I thank God for you and for your family, and I pray that His blessing will continue with you, with my sincere wishes and love for your future. Kendi.